the basketball tournament. Now we are down to two. Team Barstool, the favorites in the championship game, taking on the fighting alumni. Notre Dame alums together again. One game, winner take all, and the take, $500,000. It's next. Boston University, we welcome you to the first ever championship game of the basketball tournament. Tonight, Team Barstool will take on the Notre Dame Fighting Alumni. And it is great to have you with us as we welcome you courtside here to Case Gym alongside Malcolm Huckabee, former guard for the Miami Heat. And for Boston College, I am Eric Freed. This is a unique tournament. It's really caught fire over the last few weeks. A lot of interest, a lot of excitement. And it is a big time atmosphere and vibe in this building here, Malcolm.
Eric, it is all about the check. $500,000 on the line. I feel like Happy Gilmore. The talent in this tournament has been unbelievable. You said it started off with 32. We're down to two teams. It's going to be physical. It's going to be intense. And at the end of the day, Eric, somebody's going home with a lot of money, baby.
There is a big fake check that says Notre Dame Fighting Alumni on it as well. So they're ready for anything here tonight. Here's what's at stake. $500,000 to be split amongst the winning team. Up to $50,000 per player just for winning this game here tonight. The loser gets nothing. Team Barstool, based out of Boston via Barstool Sports. They won the first four games of the tournament by an average of 10.5 points a game. The Notre Dame Fighting Alumni, every player but one played for Mike Bray at Notre Dame. Together, they played well together as a team, winning their four games by an average of 16 points a game. Time to meet the teams. Time for the starting lineups. Let's turn it over to public address announcer Andy J.
Good evening once again, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Case Gymnasium for the basketball tournament championship game between Team Barstool and the Notre Dame Fighting Alumni. And now let's meet the starting lineups. Wearing the white uniforms, the Fighting Alumni of Notre Dame. A 6'5" guard, number 43, Russell Carter. A 6'1" guard, number 13, Chris Thomas. A 6'7" forward, number 42, Ryan Ayers. A 6'8" forward, number 1, Tyrone Nash. And a 6'9" forward, number 31, Rob Kurz. And the coach of the Fighting Alumni, Kieran Piller. And now, wearing the purple uniforms, Team Barstool. A 5'10" guard from Seton Hall, number 12, Andre Barrett. A 6'4" guard from Providence College, number 55, Donnie McGrath. A 6'9" forward from UConn, number 7, Josh Boone. A 6'6" forward from Florida, number 44, Matt Walsh. And a 6'6" forward from Duke, number 1, Dante Jones. And the coach of Team Barstool, Ross Burns.
All right, so once again, the starters for the Notre Dame Fighting Alumni, led by Chris Thomas, who was a 2,000-point scorer, class of 2005 at Notre Dame, also had 800 assists. Thomas has played very well. Carter, Nash, Kurz, and Ayers. Ryan Ayers has led Notre Dame in scoring at better than 14 points a game. For Team Barstool, Dante Jones has been outstanding. First-round pick of the Celtics back in 2003, spent 10 years around the NBA, most recently with the Hawks last year. As we mentioned, Team Barstool, Boston based, they had to get the vote out to host this game. They got all the votes, so they have the home court advantage here. Fighting Alumni will be in the green, and Team Barstool will be in the starfish purple, which is really a color scheme we've never really discussed before on any broadcast I've been a part of. And a great officiating crew, John Gaffney, Brian O'Connell, Evan Burrows here set to go at Case Gym. We will play two 18-minute halves. There will be no TV timeouts, so the game is going to keep moving. That's going to be an interesting strategy here as this game progresses. And six fouls are allowed to each team. NBA rules in that case. Josh Boone set to jump center against Ty Nash. The opening tip is controlled by the Fighting Alumni, and we're underway here at Case Gym.
Notre Dame, Eric, very balanced throughout this tournament. Five and six guys averaging over double figures. And then on the other side, Barstool, led by Dante Jones, the former Duke star.
A great look, and the finish wasn't as pretty as Ty Nash hoped it would be, but it was pretty effective. Walsh, test from deep to start, can't get it to go, and the rebound to the Fighting Alumni. Another good look inside. This is a team that shares the basketball very well, and you get a good look right from the jump of how Notre Dame has played throughout this tournament, Malcolm.
Eric, that's going to be a key theme throughout this game. Notre Dame really playing as a unit, and as I said, Barstool, they have some great individual players. Notre Dame balanced.
Barrett works it around to Matt Walsh. 24-second shot clock, and trying to beat the shot clock was Walsh, and Notre Dame comes away with the rebound. Thomas thought about the pull-up, and a whistle and a foul is called on Barstool.
Well, Eric, you can see early on the contrasting styles on offense. Team Barstool, not a lot of ball movement. Walsh now has taken two quick threes. Dante Jones, their leading scorer, has not touched the ball. On the other side, Notre Dame is swinging the ball around left to right, getting everybody involved, and they've gotten some high-quality, high-percentage looks.
Here's Thomas. Pops it down the curves, knocked away from behind. Good play by Walsh. Runs out, but they can't get it to him. And here comes Donnie McGrath, who played at such a high level for Providence College. The handoff to Andre Barrett. Count it, and the foul.
That was a NBA type and one. Andre Barrett, strong right here. Great individual play. Take the hit, go up and finish. And everybody stopped on the Notre Dame team in that situation right there. You still want to try to get up and contest the shot. Barrett got an open look and nice little floater in the lane.
And with $500,000 on the line, you got the feeling right from the beginning, and you get the feeling there. Everything is going to be debated with the officials. Things are hot in here. It's 80 degrees outside. We're at a place they call the roof because we're on the top floor, so it's going to be warm in here. Tempers will probably rise as well. Thomas gets the floater.
Such a great point guard for Notre Dame. I put him right up there with the great ones. David Rivers, I put him maybe a slight above David Rivers, but certainly David Rivers was a great player back in his day, but Chris Thomas, phenomenal, the numbers he put up at Notre Dame. Over 2,000 points, over 600 assists, and a guy that consistently got it done.
Andre Barrett, a little nifty move to get free on the baseline and put it in for two. Barrett, 32 years old now, played at Seton Hall, part of four NBA seasons with seven different franchises. Barstool gets a stop back the other way. Foul was called on Thomas. That's his first personal.
That's two possessions. Barrett's been able to break down the Notre Dame defense and get in the lane.
McGrath, unlimited range from outside the three-point line. Notre Dame knows it. McGrath will try it and make it for three. Donnie, a pro in Europe with Spartak St. Petersburg, shooting 47% from outside the arc during the tournament. Kurz tries to work inside out Walsh, strong guy. Boone comes in to get the rebound, and here's McGrath. Good early start for the Fighting Alumni, and then a takeaway by Thomas in for two.
And Nice D that time by Thomas. Just picked McGrath's pocket and an easy deuce.
8-7, Fighting Alumni. And now Team Barstool on top. Great start for Andre Barrett, averaging nearly 12 points a game in the tournament, but more importantly, better than 8 assists a game. He's been doing with scoring because he's been taking it to the basket.
He's so quick, and the thing you worry about in these games, guys obviously are not in top shape. Fatigue may be a factor, but early on, we're seeing some great offense.
3-pointer answered from the Fighting Alumni, and they go back on top by 2. And another whistle on Notre Dame.
Looks like Dante Jones wants to do the work in the post. He's a guy that's been averaging 21 points in the 4 games in this tournament. You know, that's going to be a key for Notre Dame. Can they stop and keep this guy with the ball under control?
Foul was on Russell Carter, his first, and now Nash picks up his second personal foul. Again, you're allowed 6 personal fouls here in the tournament. Substitution, and this is an interesting addition. Torrin Francis, who played at a high level for Notre Dame, he was unable to play with the team in their 4 games last weekend in Philadelphia because he was playing in the Venezuelan League Championship Series last weekend. But he was on the roster, able to make it here this weekend, and he's off the bench to play his first minutes of the tournament. Boone on the glass. Hard on the offensive glass. Thomas goes down, and a timeout being awarded here, or did they call the traveling violation? I think they're calling the traveling violation. It'll be Barstool basketball.
Yeah, and I think they got it right. I don't think he got the timeout in time. He was sliding on the floor before he can get the timeout. So great effort, as we knew there would be in this game. Guys getting after it. $500,000 on the line.
Here's Walsh. Good move. Can't get it to go. And Ryan Ayers with the rebound. Ayers has been the leading scorer during the tournament. Carter trying another 3. That almost went down. And the rebound comes out to Barrett. 2-point lead for Notre Dame here in the first half. McGrath defended by Thomas. Thomas has been out of the game. He's been playing in a men's league in Indianapolis. But this tournament, he says, has relit his fire. And on fire in the first half is Andre Barrett. 8 points and a chance to add to it.
Well, when you have a guy this quick, you have to give him space. There is no way you're going to get up and stop him individually. That's just a mismatch in the lane, finished with the left. They're going to have to think about giving him more space, Eric, and force him to shoot jump shots.
Challenged by Francis and by Kurz. They give the foul to Kurz, and Barrett finishes the 3-point play. He has 9 of Barstool's 12 first half points. $500,000 on the line, winner take all here at Boston University. Carter to Francis. Boone, an excellent shot blocker, has his hands full and gets called for the foul, and they say do not count the basket. You can see on the Notre Dame side of things protesting the fact that they did not get the field goal and a chance for a 3-point play after Barstool had been awarded something similar earlier in the half.
Well, Eric, I have a feeling everything's going to be contested in this game. Every call, every possession under the microscope. Obviously, big payday on the line for both teams.
Justin Burrell comes into the game, replacing Josh Boone. Burrell, former player for St. John's, 1,000-point scorer for the Red Storm, class of 2011. Another whistle, another foul called. It will be the 3rd team foul on Barstool. And the first personal on Dante Jones. Torrey Jackson into the game for the Fighting Alumni, wearing number 3. Class of 2010. Kurz is fouled by Walsh.
Nice little just back down move, really individual, no help from Barstools, and Kurz took his time. Big 6'9 forward from Philly, and just a great individual move. And we talked about this, Eric, the depth that this Notre Dame team has, and also the familiarity with these guys. These guys seem like they have been playing together for a very long time, and it shows in the flow of their offense. Everybody getting touches. The ball is not sticking on one side, and then they continue to get some high-quality shots.
Fouls on Burrell, his first personal, and a couple of free throws for Rob Kurz. Well, one thing the Fighting Alumni have talked about, they've played up this underdog role. They say they kind of had that underdog role in college. It's the way they've been talking now. That three-pointer by McGrath is off the mark, and a rebound for the Fighting Alumni. Ayers has it knocked away. Walsh has it for Barstool. Barrett again with a nice move, but can't finish this time. And away with it is Russell Carter. Carter drives the lane. Knocked away. Taken away by Dante Jones. Now out to Barrett. Barrett McGrath for three.
And that was all set up by the defense of Dante Jones. Barrett with the quick push. And that's a beautiful find in transition.
2-point lead for Team Barstool. Francis can't get the reverse, and Walsh has the rebound. McGrath's knocked down a couple of three-pointers. Ayers is going to chase him through. Walsh to the basket for two. First points for Matt Walsh, Malcolm.
And that time Walsh didn't settle for the jumper. Got to the lane, was able to finish.
Barstool playing with a six-man rotation. Notre Dame's ready to work in a couple more players in. Francis inside. He gets his first two of the evening.
Great ball movement. Three, four guys involved. Little up fake in the lane. One more unselfish basketball.
Homecoming for Francis. Grew up in Boston. He's got quite a few friends and family. They're expecting upwards of 50 friends and family to come support him.
I wonder how much they want of his cut if they win. You know it. Well, somebody's going to ask for something more than a nice little dinner.
You held up the big check, but one of the things in this tournament, they are handing real checks out to the players and general managers after the game. They determined beforehand what the cut's going to be. It's up to $50,000. Some guys make a little less if they're only playing this weekend. But they're going to hand out the real thing. So if you go out to dinner afterwards and you're showing that check around, a three-pointer is knocked down by Walsh. He has five. Everybody knows you have deep pockets if you go out in Boston tonight.
Well, I'll tell you what. I got one of my guys, probably shouldn't say it on air, going to see if we can cash that fake check. So that baby might bounce. But Walsh is starting to heat up for Team Barstool.
Good answer by Francis, though, after Barstool stretched it out to five. 3 threes made by Team Barstool so far. Two by Donnie McGrath, who has it knocked away. He's in trouble. And it will be Notre Dame ball.
Well, Eric, we talked about the intensity of this game. That's a great hedge on the ball screen right there. Guys getting after it in the passing lane. And that time Notre Dame was able to come up with a steal.
Paul Gause, the only non-Notre Dame player on this Fighting Alumni roster. He played at Seton Hall, class of 09. He was recruited by Notre Dame, actually. A lot of these guys, as you well know, Malcolm, play AAU together. They see each other quite a bit. So he's got a friend who knows a friend, and here he is playing for $500,000.
Goss had a great high school career, one of the better ones coming out of Jersey. Scored over 3,100 points in high school. And the only other guy to do that in his state, DeJuan Wagner. So you know he can fill it up.
Trip to the free throw line coming up. It's a three-point game here. About 9.5 minutes to go in the first half. And we are joined now by Notre Dame head coach Mike Bray, who thinks so highly of the Fighting Alumni that he flew into Boston, taken to dinner last night, first and foremost, and to come see the game here tonight, Mike.
Still on scholarship. How about that? These guys, I told them last night, still on scholarship. And it's just neat to be with them. I mean, these guys are like sons to me, to kind of get them all back together and hang out and tell some stories. And I'm really proud of them, you know, the stuff they've been doing here. This is a great matchup. And, boy, Barstool's really talented. But, you know, it's been fun. I think this event, wow.
It's been great.
This is a great event. It's only going to take off and be more popular. And I wouldn't be surprised if it's on national TV, next year.
You were talking to your guys at dinner in Boston last night. You flew in last night. You got them all together. What have they said about the event, about how it's been run, and just how that has really upped the profile of it in a very short period of time?
First class all the way. You know, and I could tell walking in here just how first class it is all the way, how they run stuff, how they put it together, treating everybody like they're NBA players, really. And they got a nice crowd in here tonight, and two good teams going at it. I just think it's just going to grow and grow. And I have a feeling the purse is going to get bigger, too.
Coach, we held up that big check at the beginning. And I tell you what, I think there's going to be a lot more interest in this thing. Coach, a basketball question. What do you see early on here? I know you got the coach's hat on all the time.
We're fouling a little too much. We have a hard time with Barrett. I'd love to see us face guard him, like Torrey face guard him now. Don't let him get it back, because, man, is he making things happen for them. He's such a talented player, and I remember him from back at Seton Hall. That was pretty good. That's the best ball screen defense we've had all night. So I think if we could be a little better on the ball screen, that could help us. But, you know, an advantage we may have is, you know, we've got some depth at the point spot that can put a fresh body on Andre Barrett. But I remember Josh Boone, Dante Jones, Donnie McGrath. We played against at Providence, played against all these guys.
Coach, we know that, Coaches for Cancer is near and dear for you. And tell us about what these guys have offered up to you if they do win the $500,000 purse.
Yeah, they're going to donate $50,000 to my charity, Coaches versus Cancer, which is the chosen charity of the National Association of Basketball Coaches. I've been part of it since my days at Delaware in the mid-90s. We've raised over $2 million in the South Bend, Michiana area, and that was just such a nice gesture of those guys to kind of put it toward our charity. We have a lot of events coming up this summer to raise money, but it sure would be nice to get one of those big cardboard checks presented at the golf tournament. Maybe Chris Thomas can present that if they can pull this off.
What can you tell us about the kind of the character of this group? Because they've talked quite a bit about how it's like they never left Notre Dame, that they're running some of the stuff they did under you. I guess, once a Mike Bray guy, always a Mike Bray guy, right?
They're running a lot of our sets, their feel for the game. We kind of built the program on offensive efficiency and, great ball movement and knowing how to play. And they've done that to date. But they got to slow this guy down or it's going to be a long night.
Now, you coached in this gym quite a few times back in your Delaware days, right?
Yes.
Against BU.
And I didn't have many fun nights in Case Gym. Delaware, I texted Dennis Wolf on the way over here. I said, I'm coming to Case Gym. And I didn't have many fun nights. I hope my guys have a better night than me. But a lot of memories here from the old America East, Boston U, Delaware.
Coach, I love what you do with the program. You're going on your 15th year. You don't see that a lot in college basketball. Tell us about your season coming up. How are you guys going to be?
Well, we want to bounce back. I mean, the ACC rudely welcomed us last year. It's gotten to be the best league. And we got baptized by fire, you could say. And we need a Daplin, baby. We need a Daplin.
You are allowed to cheerlead.
Mr. Basketball in the state of it. One of my first, one of our early recruits who kind of endorsed my program when he stayed with us and came to Notre Dame. And his numbers, career numbers, Chris Thomas, are off the charts. I'm amazed. He hasn't played much, but
he looks pretty good.
He's got a great feel for it. He really does.
Well, me and Eric were joking early on. I said, I put him as one of the top, and you guys had a lot of great point guards. David Rivers.
Right.
I remember watching this young man play and loved his game, and he did a lot.
He's as good as any of them. You're right, Malcolm.
Three-pointer.
That's our ringer.
You recruited him, didn't you?
We did. Yeah. We did recruit him.
Here's Barrett, can't get to the basket this time, but Jones, who has been lights out in this tournament.
Barrett is just such a bear in the lane, and that's a tough one to stop.
Here is Thomas.
Wow, we needed that.
There's no rust on that game. There's no rust. All right, we're going to turn you loose so you can be full cheerleader if you want, Mike. We appreciate the time, and it's great to see you out here rooting for your guys.
Good to be with you guys. And do you get a cut of the money, by the way?
No, we do not.
Let me work on that at halftime.
Coach, that cardboard check, one of my guys is running to the bank to see if they can cash that baby.
We need that one.
All right.
See you guys.
Mike Bray, thanks so much.
Thank you so much.
Appreciate it. It's Mike Bray, the Notre Dame head coach, joining us here at the tournament. It's a three-point game. Team Barstool on top. A little over 6 minutes to go here in the opening half. Jones had been quiet in the opening moments of this game, but getting on track, knocking down the three. Misses that one. And here comes Notre Dame down by three. Make it down by one. Goaltending.
It's been back and forth. We're seeing a lot of good individual plays. And, yep, the referees got that one right. And I think, again, fatigue will play into this game as we get deeper into this game.
One-point lead. Barstool with the ball. Jones knocked out of his hands, looking for the foul. None coming. Thomas to Nash, Kurz, rebound for Barstool. 5.5 to play, first half. McGrath will slow things down. It is warm in this building. Walsh comes off strong on the three. Boone's been a monster on the glass, though, here in the first half. Turns that one over, though. Thomas running after it, can't get it. Good hustle play by Jones to keep it alive for Barstool. McGrath slows things down. 5 minutes to go here in the first half. A look away to Burrell and the foul on the cut to the basket.
That's an unselfish play that time by Dante Jones. Now he had a smaller Chris Thomas on him. Instead of forcing the shot, he saw the cutter, hit him in stride for a pretty good look.
Couple of free throws coming up for Burrell.
So most guys, Eric, right here, if you're selfish, they would have tried to bat the guy down and force up a shot. Jones, unselfish in that situation right there, made a beautiful pass to a cutter.
Justin Burrell most recently played pro ball in France. Can't make the first free throw. But we talked about the bench. Notre Dame's been moving players in and out. There are reserves on the Barstool bench, but not all of them will play. Dave Portnoy and Dan Katz, El Prez and Big Cat in Barstool language, they're on the bench. They're a big reason why the game is here. They're fans, they're stoolies, got the vote out. But there they are. They're the bench mob.
I love it. El Presidente.
We talked to Ross Burns, the GM and coach, before the game, getting him to commit to what it would take to get them in the game. And he said he would play before those two guys got into the game. So I don't think we're going to see El Prez and Big Cat unless there's a cigar being lit on the bench. There's a three for Kurz.
Well, Eric, you can just see the ball movement and how fluid it is on offense for this Notre Dame team. I think Coach Bray has been coaching these guys up prior to this tournament. I mean, they are just playing like they've been playing together for 3-4 years.
Illegal screen called on Boone. That will be his second personal foul.
Well, with six fouls, I'm not too concerned about him 4 minutes to go in this first. And you certainly do not want Josh Boone. And, yeah, I think also Thomas folded a little bit, but certainly you can't do that right in front of the referee.
Josh, of course, a standout at UConn, part of the national championship team in 2004. Big East Defensive Player of the Year in 2005. We've seen him protecting the rim here today. McGrath whistled for the foul. Team foul number six. Torrey Jackson back into the game for the Fighting Alumni as Chris Thomas will get a rest. By hosting the team, Barstool could dictate a very important rule. They were using a 45-second shot clock in the first four games of the tournament as Carter launches a three. That's short, but he follows his own miss and a reset for Notre Dame. Barstool said they wanted a 24-second shot clock. They wanted the tempo to stay up in this game, even though they don't have a deep bench. But the way Notre Dame can move the basketball and work possessions as Nash goes to the basket, they thought a 24-second shot clock would pay dividends for them. So far, Notre Dame has looked pretty good, up by four.
Well, I do think, agree with that strategy, though. Notre Dame, if you give them 45 seconds and they have a lead, they will pick you apart and then probably get some really good looks with the shot clock winding down. So Barstool is right to get the game up and down.
McGrath, tough take to the basket for two. He has a Barrett and a quick nine. Those are the two top scorers for Team Barstool in a two-point game. Three is too strong. Barrett has the rebound, has McGrath on his left. Look at the speed from Barrett, spinning and getting fouled.
He is so quick getting up and down the court. Barrett has been the story for Barstool. We're going to take a look right here. Rebound. And this is just Allen Iverson speed coming at you. Barrett getting up the court in a hurry. And that's going to be something, Eric, for Notre Dame, keeping him out of the lane. Early on in this first half, they've been unable to keep him out of the lane, whether it's in transition or in sets. So I think they need to give him more space, as I talked about. He's too quick to get up and try to defend one-on-one. Give him space and force him to shoot jump shots.
Barrett went for 13 points, 17 assists in the tournament opening beatdown of Barstool Philly. Grudge match between Barstool, Team Barstool based out of Boston, and Barstool Philly. And our first timeout being called here of the first half. Even at 33, between the Notre Dame Fighting Alumni, who rolled in their last game, they beat the Peace Players 91-61, each of their four wins in this tournament by double figures as you look into their huddle. And the Team Barstool huddle with head coach Ross Burns.
Well, Eric, you can see the strategy for Barstool. They want to get up, make or miss, try to get out and get some early offense. They got plenty of shooters on the wing. Dante Jones has been quiet, but I think as this game continues to pick up, they need to continue to involve him in the offense. Nobody to this point has been able to stop him. And then on the other side, if you're Notre Dame, you just want to keep doing what you're doing. Good ball movement, everybody touching the rock, and then try to get some high percentage either jumpers off of movement or some backdoor cuts.
Well, we've talked about Jones being the leader for Barstool and Thomas for the Fighting Alumni, but how about the supporting crew? Like a guy like Ty Nash has 8 points so far in the first half, making this a tie game.
And that's what I talked about in the open, the balance of Notre Dame. They have 6 to 8 guys that are averaging in double digits in these first four games, and you can see ball movement. It just looks and feels the flow of the game like they've been moving the ball and they've been playing together for a long time.
Notre Dame basketball out of the timeout. With 3 minutes to go in the first half, Thomas back on the floor. He's leading Notre Dame in scoring with 11 here in the first half. Kurz can't get it. Walsh the rebound.
Really love how Barrett just probes the floor, always looking to set up his teammates.
Walsh lost the handle. Turnover. Back the other way. That won't go, and McGrath has the rebound. Ryan Ayers only with 2 points so far for Fighting Alumni, as that's thrown out of play. Play getting a little sloppy here. Saw his dad, Randy Ayers, in the building here. He's here to watch his son play. As you take a look at Ross Burns, I think I spotted Luke Herangode, Notre Dame alum in the building here. And what we're hearing from tournament officials and talking to these teams, as players around the country saw how this tournament was being run and what was on the line, there's a lot of knocking on the door trying to get on these teams and trying to be a part of the tournament and try to get a piece of that $500,000.
I'm already on it. GM, I can't go anymore. The ankle won't do it, but I tell you what.
You're putting together Team BC next year?
Well, I'll tell you what, I'm going out. I'm pulling out all the punches. I'm going with the best players, best man available. That's what I'm putting together. But the talent level and the play in this tournament, Eric, has been phenomenal. March Madness is over. The NBA Finals and also draft has passed us. And if you're a basketball junkie and you want to see high-quality basketball and guys getting after it, I'll tell you what, the basketball tournament has a chance to be really special.
First year, even tournament organizers will admit to you that it's exceeded their expectations because they called this a test run. Well, this test has looked pretty good. Three-pointer from Walsh, shot's not there. Thomas has the rebound. Less than 2 minutes to play. Now Walsh takes it away and puts it in.
Well, Walsh missed the open look. Sticking with it on the defensive end, he was able to pick the ball clean for easy, uncontested deuce.
He's getting some heat, though, from his teammates. Big Cat and El Prez, they wanted him to dunk it. He went with the layup. And now a foul is called on the Fighting Alumni. Thomas gets whistled.
This is just great team defense. Nice little crossover by Thomas. And then Walsh stepping in, giving up his body. I think the referees got it right on that. Walsh was set. Thomas, little out of control, and Walsh comes up with a big turnover for his team.
Kicked outside to Jones. Jones can't get it. Followed his own miss, still fighting for it. And last touch by Notre Dame. Shot clock had expired, and the officials got together quickly. They do have video replay if they need it, but it wouldn't be for this call. They put 1 second on the shot clock. And now Evan Burroughs.
I'll tell you what.
Play peacemaker here before things get put back into play.
500 grand on the line, and if me and you were broadcasting for 500 grand and I had to go against you, you would have to have some elbow pads, face mask, and everything, because it would get physical and it would be contested and heated.
But I can take it. Jones' shot, now Walsh on the reach. Jones' shot to beat the shot clock was off the iron, and then Walsh gets called for the foul. That'll be his second personal foul. 17 fouls now on Team Barstool. A couple of free throws coming now for Rob Kurz. Spent time in the Celtics and Golden State organizations. Didn't play pro ball this past year. Makes the first.
A really good defender at Notre Dame. He's sixth all time in the history of Notre Dame in shots blocked. 122 for his career while he was at Notre Dame.
Tied at 35. Final minute of play, first half. Looks like they're trying to find Jones here. 5 points so far from the leading scorer for Barstool in this tournament, averaging better than 21 a game.
That time, Kurz got switched off on Jones, and he was salivating. Move out of the way, clear out. Pull up jumper.
Francis in the paint tries to get a little room. Good defense by Team Barstool. They can hold for a final shot. Walsh leans in for a three. Barrett with the rebound. Jones will launch a three and gets it.
Well, Andre Barrett has been the problem for Notre Dame, whether it's offensive rebounds, penetrating and kicking. And that time, that's just a beautiful find.
To beat the buzzer, won't go down, and it'll be a lead for Team Barstool at halftime. Big sequence there. They got the stop from Francis. Walsh forced a three on one end, but they get the second chance. And Dante Jones ends up in double figures in the first half with 10.
Well, it was an impressive first half, Eric, and Notre Dame started off running their offense well, getting some good looks. And you thought Barstool was going to be in trouble, and then they just bounced right back. Offensive rebounds, loose balls, and then Andre Barrett has been the key for them in that first half, whether it's getting his own offense or finding other guys for wide open looks.
40-35 the score at halftime. And Team Barstool head coach and general manager Ross Burns joins us now. We're just talking about it with Malcolm, Ross. It seems Andre Barrett got things started for you attacking the basket. What did you think of the first half?
You know, it was good. We came out a little hesitant, but then Dre got us going, pushed the pace, and we got some baskets, and we played okay.
Coach, in the second half, you guys aren't that deep, but you guys were obviously able to get a lot of open looks for Andre Barrett. What do you think you need to do against this Notre Dame team in the second half?
I mean, first it starts with defense. If we get stops, we get the ball to Dre, we get good looks in transition. So it's important we stop and we rebound. And then on offense, we got to do a better job of keeping our sets tight and getting into our offense.
Ross, thanks for your time. Best of luck the rest of the way.
All right, thanks.
Ross Burns, head coach. He's the director of Pro Hoops Training down in New York City. Working with this group here for the second week in a row, trying to win $500,000. And at halftime, Team Barstool is on top of the Notre Dame Fighting Alumni. It was a good start for Notre Dame. They came out on the run, but answered back by Andre Barrett and eventually by Dante Jones. And Team Barstool on top by five at the half here in Boston with $500,000 on the line. Halftime here, Case Jim in Boston. Team Barstool on top of the Notre Dame Fighting Alumni, 40-35, $500,000 to the winning team here tonight. We're joined now by the head coach and GM for Notre Dame, Kieran Piller, who, well, Mike Bray's here. Did you talk to Coach Bray at all about any halftime adjustments, or you got it all set there?
We didn't talk to him at all during the game, but we talked to him a little bit last night about what we wanted to do, and you know, we know what we have to do in the second half here. It's pretty clear cut.
Coach, Andre Barrett was pretty problematic early on in that first half. What adjustment do you think you need to make against him?
I think we need to get Torrey Jackson and Paul Dawes out there a little more so they can match up with him. Give CT a break a little bit, give Chris Thomas a break. And, you know, we gambled too much. We just need to play more solid defense.
Tell us about your team a little bit. It seems like it's a group of guys who never left South Bend, that they picked up where they left off. Has that been your experience coaching these guys
guys? It's absolutely. It's like riding a bike, you know what I mean? The principles are there. You know, we all played under the same system, so even though guys didn't play at the same time, you know, they all know what they're doing. So it's been real easy, and, you know, the first half, offense wasn't our problem. We weren't making shots, but we were getting great shots, so the chemistry is there.
We appreciate your time. Best of luck the rest of the way.
Thank you very much.
That's the head coach and GM for the Fighting Alumni, Kieran Piller, who was a walk-on at Notre Dame, graduate of Notre Dame Law School. In charge of this Notre Dame team that jumped out to a 6-2 lead as we take you through the first half highlights. And they were getting good looks, as he just mentioned, in that first 18 minutes.
Early on, Notre Dame was putting on a clinic on the offensive end. And you see here, Chris Thomas picking up an easy deuce. And the ball movement. Chris Thomas coming off the screen right there. No heads by Barstool. And then for Barstool, they have some great individual players. Right there in the grass, throwing off the jumper. Nice push by Barrett. Unselfish with the ball. And then Walsh knocking down jumpers. He's a guy that's starting to heat up a little bit. So Dante Jones, though, has been the story of this tournament early on. Averaging 21 points a game. And he's a guy that Notre Dame is going to have to be careful with in the second half. He can light it up.
And on the shooting numbers in the first half, 6 of 13 from outside the three-point line for Team Barstool, plus 6 in rebounding margin. 2 points in the paint, an advantage for Notre Dame. Individually, scoring leader for Notre Dame in the first half, Chris Thomas with 11. Andre Barrett had 11 for Team Barstool. Dante Jones had 10. Team Barstool went on a 7-0 run to close out that first half. It will be their basketball to start the second half here at BU. 18 minutes away from a $500,000 payout. Did you turn over that big check or no?
$500,000. I know that's chump change for you, but for guys like us, that's a lot of dough somebody's going home with.
Donnie McGrath comes out, can't get the three, and a rebound for Russell Carter. Have your BC friends been checking in with you during the first half when you said you're putting a team together?
Everybody, man, is coming out of the woodworks. I'll tell you what, this thing is going to really take off. And what a format.
Ty Dash on the inside, 4-2. Again, it began last weekend in Philadelphia at Philadelphia University with 32 teams. Single elimination tournament whittled down to these final two teams. They played 4 games last weekend. Championship game here, Barrett. Check that Jones stepping out of bounds. Turnover, Barstool.
And Eric, we really haven't seen much sloppy play right there, just careless with the ball. But thus far in that first half, we saw some high quality basketball, some great individual plays, and for Notre Dame, great ball movement.
Thomas returns it, and it's thrown down by Nash.
All set up by Chris Thomas. Beautiful pick and roll player. Dropped it for dime. No help for Barstool.
Back to a 1-point game. Jones spinning, dropping it down, but it's knocked away. Good defensive play by Kurz. And last touch by Notre Dame. Barstool ball.
And on that last play, Boone's got to give Jones an angle to pass to. He was going behind a defender. He drew the defender. You got to step to the short corner and try to set yourself up for a little 10-foot jumper.
Barrett to beat the shot clock, nick the iron, and it's taken by Notre Dame. Throws it in. Nash trying to work on Dante Jones, and a foul called on Dante Jones. That'll be his second personal foul.
Jones has given up a lot of size there to Ty Nash, and that's a matchup. If I'm Notre Dame, I'm going back to see if you can exploit the size advantage.
So here's Ty Nash to the free throw line, 11 of 13 from the floor in the last two games, 74% for the tournament. He's leading the way today with 13 points. Was 4 for 5 from the field in the first half, and you saw the loud dunk a moment ago. Played pro ball in Germany this past season.
Very active player for Notre Dame during his career. Energy guy.
The chant, "Let's go Barstool." McGrath, that's short. Really good crowd has come into Case Gym here tonight. See this first ever championship game of the basketball tournament. Thomas Kurz is going to try at three. Dante Jones. Jones is fouled. He'll go to the free throw line to shoot two.
That's a great individual effort by Jones. First on the defensive end, great box out. And then he just took the ball coast to coast, and he's so strong, so explosive. Look at this right here. Get the rebound, nice block out, and then I'm just going coast to coast. I'm not giving this up. And Jones is so explosive there, so strong. He looks awfully good, and in this tournament, really has been the guy for Barstool, averaging 21 points a game.
And he's been so good getting to the free throw line, leading the team in free throw attempts. Through the first four games, makes the first 589 career NBA games for Dante Jones, 38 playoff games. Barstool's on top by one. Three-pointer is good. Ryan Ayers has 5 points, and Notre Dame has a 2-point lead. Jones, nice feed to Boone, and he was fouled by Kurz. That'll be the third personal foul on Rob Kurz.
Well, yeah, both teams really unselfish with the ball. In a pressure situation like this, the team that typically continues to run their offense, be unselfish with the ball, and not try to do too much individually is the team that wins. And right now, both teams are being unselfish with the ball, and they're getting some high percentage looks.
Josh Boone makes the first. 3 points go along with 5 rebounds for Boone. Had a block in the first half as well. 1 of 2, 1 point game. Extra pass, Thomas, wide open three.
Well, if you want to show young players how to run your offense, that last play right there by Notre Dame was a clinic. Penetration, kick, one more pass to a wide open shooter.
Walsh lost the handle, has help from Boone. He'll go back to the free throw line.
I'm going to take a look at this Notre Dame possession. And this is just beautiful basketball. Come off a little screen right here. Break a guy down individually. Don't force a shot. Kick it. One more pass. And that's going back to that unselfishness, Eric, where guys are willing to make that extra pass for a better look for their teammate.
Burrell comes into the game for Walsh for Team Barstool.
Take a look at Josh Boone here. Played on that great UConn squad. He's a guy that declared as a junior 2006. He was a 23rd overall pick by New Jersey. And you know, early on in his career, dealt with some injuries. Showed a lot of promise in some of the early summer league games. And then he tore his labrum, had some other little nagging issues, and just never really was healthy early on in his NBA career.
struggle at the free throw line for Boone, shooting 50% for the tournament. 4-point lead for Notre Dame. They have the basketball. Nash back for Ayers. McGrath fighting through the screen, dropped down low, knocked away, but into the hands of Thomas in the corner. The three to beat the shot clock won't go down. Barrett, that's what he did so well in the first half, and Boone finishes.
Early in the second half, Notre Dame did a pretty decent job of keeping Barrett out of the lane. That time in a scramble situation, Barrett is so quick, he just breaks you down, and that's a beautiful dime.
2-point lead for Notre Dame. Deep three coming, too strong, and Burrell has another rebound. Barrett blows by Nash, pulls up, rebound for Boone. Dante Jones. Jones can't get it to go. Ended up back in his hands, trying to throw it off Fighting Alumni leg, and it's taken away by Notre Dame. Nash working hard. They play on. Good job by Dante Jones. Not the foul, and here's Barrett. Gets half a step on Thomas. Kicks it out. Wide open look, McGrath. That normally goes down, not this time. Thomas back for Ayers. Ayers, three ball. Let's go. Ryan Ayers has eight. The Notre Dame lead is five.
That's two big threes by Ayers. And again, unselfish by Thomas. Fatigue right there. Nobody closed out on the shooter and left Ayers wide open.
Spins with the left hand. No. Boone with the left hand. The tip is good.
Boone has been very active on the offensive glass. I count that two, three times now in the second half where he's been able to just outwork Notre Dame on the boards.
Foul called on Dante Jones. That will be his third personal foul. Team second. Substitutions for the Fighting Alumni. Torrey Jackson and Torrin Francis into the game. Matt Walsh comes back in for Team Barstool as Dante Jones will head to the bench. Fighting Alumni ball on the side. Here's Jackson. Francis just into the game. Burrell, another rebound. Done a good job on the glass here off the bench. Barrett. McGrath got in deep. They have to reset. Less than 12 to play. McGrath from the corner, no.
Another good look for Barstool. Just unable to knock down those open looks that are set up by Barrett penetration.
Illegal screen called on the Fighting Alumni. Ty Nash gets whistled for his third personal foul. Barrett left open for three.
And that's what you want to do if you're Notre Dame. Slide under the screen and do not allow Barrett to get into the lane.
3-point game. $500,000 to the winning team. Ash accelerates. They say foul before the shot. Burrell picks up his second personal foul. Again, each player allowed six personal fouls in this 36-minute game. Josh Boone will get a rest as Dante Jones comes back in. Ross Burns hasn't had a lot to work with in trying to get guys a little bit of rest here on a warm night here in Case Gym, the roof at Boston University. 10 on the shot clock. Francis tries to work on Burrell. Down to 3 on the shot clock. Burrell has the rebound.
One of the few poor possessions for Notre Dame.
Jones, tough shot. Count it. And the foul.
He is so tough, so strong. Look at the body control, pushing the ball up the floor, Barrett, and then take the hit and finish. Big time play by Dante Jones. And Eric talked about end of the game situations as this thing starts to tighten up. It's been back and forth. I give a slight advantage to Barstool because when you need a play, a guy to get you a bucket, end of the game situation, Dante Jones is a handful to guard.
Jones can't get the free throw. Fouls on Ty Nash, his 4th personal foul. Russell Carter. Jackson. Francis fights on the glass, second chance. Back outside to Carter. Francis. Nash, tough shot, count it! And a trip to the free throw line coming up for Ty Nash.
Here, Ty Nash has got a very quick first step. You see this right here. Now, nice little kick out, and then his first step is quick. If you close out, as Dante Jones did that time, with your legs straight, he's going to blow by you every time. Ty Nash showing off some nice offensive moves.
One free throw for Nash. Averaging nearly 12 points a game during the tournament. Above that here tonight, and adds to it.
He's just got a great feel for the game. Plays within himself. But boy, when he gets his opportunities, he can explode to the rim.
McGrath worked it inside, and Jones walks. Timeout being called by Team Notre Dame. There's a lot of pressure on in this game here this afternoon. There's some pressure on that man right there, Russell Carter. He is supposed to be the best man in the wedding of former Notre Dame football player Joe Brockington. But he is blowing off the wedding to attend this game here tonight. Brockington told him that he'd miss the wedding too if he stood to win $50,000. Not if he was the groom, probably, but maybe he's the best man. We don't want Joe's fiance to get upset here. So Brockington said, you better win, and when you do, you better get us a nice gift with your cut.
I'll tell you what, that better not be a box of plates. That better not be some crystal. I don't know, man. He might have to get him something really nice, but certainly the Notre Dame community, you see Coach Bray here, it's a tight-knit group, and certainly, Eric, they've had a lot of fun with this. I would miss a wedding if it $50,000 was on the line for myself. I'd send you a nice gift. Send me the tape, but certainly I would not miss this opportunity to put a little extra pocket change in your pocket.
Guys like Luke Herangode turning out to root on the Fighting Alumni here in Boston.
I tell you what, I think next year you're just going to see. Now, we saw a lot of quality players in this tournament for the first year. I think next year it's only going to go up.
Four-point lead for Notre Dame. They have the basketball. Less than 10 minutes to play in this winner-take-all championship game of the inaugural basketball tournament. Notre Dame's got some confidence now. Gaws into the game. Kicks it outside, down to 5 on the shot clock. An illegal screen called on Francis. Ayers knocked down the 3, but no basket. Francis called for the foul.
And the referee's got it right. He was certainly moving as he was going to set that screen. And right in front of the referees.
Two personals now on Francis. making his Fighting alumni debut here in the championship game. Here's Burrell. Nash playing with four fouls. McGrath to Jones. Jones open look, that's short. Defended by McGrath. Boone's watching. Now Francis. Francis. That won't go. Boone the rebound. Notre Dame's getting back on defense, Malcolm. The transition opportunities have not been there for Team Barstool, and the three-point shooting has cooled off for Team Barstool as well. Walsh will try and have to change his shot because Nash challenged it.
Yeah, and that's not a good look that time by Walsh. It's a contested NBA three, and nobody really has touched the ball.
Fouls called on Burrell.
And this is where the depth of that Notre Dame team comes in. I think fatigue now playing a huge factor late in this game. Barstool looks a little bit tired offensively and defensively.
16 fouls now on. Check it, 5 team fouls now on Team Barstool. Have to play in a four-point game. Well, as Malcolm has mentioned, you check the website, Ayers is all pumped up.
He is on fire. Catch, shoot, defense wasn't that bad, but Ayers has hit some tough threes.
And then an answer by Walsh and a chance at the free throw line to make it a three-point play.
And that's what Walsh needs to do more of. I think he's settled early in the game. And now in the second half, he's got decent size, he's got good length, and everybody knows he can shoot the ball. Nice little hesitation, make it easy on yourself, get to the hole.
First points of the second half for Matt Walsh, who played for Florida. He's in the double figures now with 10. Been a busy week. His wife gave birth to a daughter, Mia, on Wednesday. Their second child flew back into Boston Friday. He's promised mom, his wife, I'll be home Sunday morning to help with the baby, I promise. But first, a little business here, trying to win his share of $500,000.
And I'm sure she told him to come home with that check.
Ash has had a real strong game. 17 points now for Ty Nash. 6-point lead for the Fighting Alumni.
The Nash and Ayers. And the second half for Notre Dame.
Walsh tries to spin. That won't go. Barrett comes in to try to keep it alive. Picked up by Boone. Stripped away by Kurz. Fighting alumni ball. Ayers. Not this time. But look at Notre Dame fighting on the inside. And a trip to the free throw line. Guards couldn't get the easy one, but they'll have a chance at the line to shoot a couple.
Well, there's that effort again, and we talked about the legs of Barstool. Notre Dame now getting all the loose balls.
So Guards steps to the line looking for his first points. Played in England professionally this past season. Can't get that one. Notre Dame also added Colin Falls to the roster. Well, he was part of the roster, but he's with the team here tonight. Wasn't able to join the Fighting Alumni and play for Kieran Pillar in Philadelphia because he had his trip in South America. Work calls, so he had to be in South America. I don't think he was taking a World Cup. 7-point lead for the Fighting Alumni. This is where Dante Jones tries to take over, but Notre Dame sees it coming. They stop him at the rim, and it's Jackson back the other way. Stripped by McGrath. Stepped out of bounds. Fighting alumni basketball.
The referees are letting them play on both ends. And a lot of contact that time. No call.
Jackson to trigger the inbound. 7:03 to go in the second half. Half a million on the line in this game. Winner take all. Jackson back to Kurz. Kerrs got free and backs it in for two. 4 points in the second half for Rob Kerrs, nine in the game. Barstool keeps playing, no timeout called. Barrett in trouble in the corner. And out of bounds off of the Fighting Alumni. It's Barstool ball with 16 to shoot.
Man, is Notre Dame efficient on the offensive end and then back on the other end? If I'm Barstool, I think you got to start now having Dante Jones touch the ball on every possession and try to get to the hole. He's got Kerrs on him, and I think that's a mismatch on the perimeter.
This is the largest lead of the evening for either squad. McGrath, shot clock expires, and Notre Dame turning up the defense here in this winner-take-all game.
Well, they just look fresher, Eric. On defense, offense, they just look a lot fresher than this Barstool team.
Again, Team Barstool with a six-man rotation. Kerrs leans in, can't get it, out to McGrath. Now a chance in transition, but look at Notre Dame coming back, and Ayers comes running back to knock it out of play with a Team Barstool ball. And a timeout now being called by Team Barstool. 6 minutes exactly to go here in the second half. Ty Nash has been outstanding for the Fighting Alumni.
Well, he's been impressive. I talked about his first step right there, showing off the hops. And then when he's had his opportunities to isolate in the post, he has finished for Notre Dame, and Barstool really has had no answer for him.
9-point lead for the Fighting Alumni.
And Eric, I think that's a great timeout by Team Barstool. This is a huge possession. Right now, I'm saying Dante Jones has got to touch the ball. You don't want this thing to stretch out to double digits if your Team Barstool. There's 6 minutes to go, and I think that man right there, Dante Jones, needs to touch the ball. Everything going to the hole, spread them out, try to go one-on-one. If they collapse, kick it out to Walsh and McGrath.
In the tournament, Jones averaging nearly 22 points a game. He's gone for 20 or more in three of the four games. He has 14 tonight, and a foul is going to be called on Russell Carter for the Fighting Alumni. 18 fouls now on the Fighting Alumni.
And that's huge. Again, going back to my strategy, if I'm Team Barstool, now you're in the bonus situation, and this is where a guy like Dante Jones on the perimeter can be lethal.
1-1 front end made by Walsh. He has 11. Currently playing professionally in Italy, played in Greece and Spain and Belgium, but he said this is by far the most fun he's had playing basketball in years. His five-game tournament playing for Team Barstool. 12 points now for Walsh. 7-point lead for the Fighting Alumni. Goss has it rejected by Dante Jones. Barrett back the other way, has it knocked away, and a foul is called on the Fighting Alumni. Great defensive play by their top offensive player, Dante Jones.
Dante Jones showing off the hops. Get that out of here. And then Andre Barrett, man, is he fast up the court. Off of the block. Beautiful play that time by Jones. And then it was off to the races for Barrett.
Fourth personal foul on Kerrs. And Barrett gets his first points in the second half. And we talked with Kieran Piller at halftime, saying it was clear what they needed to do in the second half. And they've tried to take Barrett and Jones out of the game. They've been successful to this point, helping them to this lead. But Barrett now at the free throw line, the second one coming. It's a ball.
Yeah, and that's been the key for Notre Dame in the second half. They've kept Barrett, for the most part, out of the lane.
The Stoolies on their feet here in Boston. 5-point lead for the Fighting Alumni. 5.5 to play. Carter, tough shot, makes it! First points of the second half for Russell Carter. He has five. And that quiets this pro Barstool crowd for the moment.
Well, he's thinking about what type of wedding gift he's going to buy.
Boone out to Jones. Open three. Got it. Action picking up the intensity at a high level with $500 million on the line here. 5 minutes to play. Torin Francis. Francis, they play on, and Francis finishes.
Good finish that time. Boom. Referees thought it was a flop. Play on and uncontested layup.
Thomas extends the defense on McGrath. McGrath drops it to Boone. Boone somehow gets it to go.
Well, coming into this game, we talked about Dante Jones. He's been their guy on the offensive end, but I think Josh Boone is equally as important to this team. Does all the little things, finishing around the rim.
Four-point. Notre Dame lead. Make it six. Kerr's in the double figures now with 11.
Well, that's just another mismatch. Kerr's has a clear size advantage over Dante Jones, and Notre Dame recognized it and went to him.
Jones passed on the deep three and will earn a trip to the free throw line.
Well, that's why he needs to touch it on the other end. Kearns obviously has the advantage on offense in the post, and there is no way that he can guard Dante Jones on the perimeter.
Jones at the free throw line to shoot a couple, makes the first. 18 points now for Dante Jones.
Take a look at right here. Nice heads-up play by Josh Boone. A lot of times, Eric, big guys won't be able to make that pass. Josh Boone made a nice pass out of the post to a wide-open Dante Jones. Heads-up play by Josh Boone.
Ty Nash and Ryan Ayers back into the game for the Fighting Alumni. Jones adding up the points now. Now at 19 points. 4-point lead for the Fighting Alumni. They have the basketball.
Eric, what about this atmosphere? This place is rocking.
Chris Thomas. Stopped by Barrett. Ayers has the hot hand. Kerrs. Boone on the blow by. Kerrs can't make a pay. And it went on the leg of Jones. It will be Notre Dame ball.
That's a great play by Russell Carter. Getting after it on the offensive glass. Getting an extra possession for Notre Dame.
Kerrs will try again. And that goes over the top. Barstool ball.
Well, you can see Chris Thomas right there telling Kerrs that's not a good look. You want to milk some clock. You got a 4-point lead right now. 3:18 to go. You can get that look anytime. You want to work the ball around, work some clock, and then try to get a better look.
Boone sets a screen for McGrath. Jones has it back, defended by Ayers. Morrell into the game. Jones won't go down. The follow from Boone is good.
Now, late in the second half, Josh Boone has been the MVP for Team Barstool.
2-point game. Nash. Carter came in to help on the glass. We'll reset. Carter, wild shot. That won't go. Rebound for Burrell. A chance to tie with a two to go ahead with a three. Barrett lost the handle and gets called for the foul.
Barrett just lost the ball. Nobody near him and fumbled it. That's a big turnover in a crucial situation. 2:29 to go, and we're trailing by two with an opportunity on fast break.
Ross Burns is going to take a timeout. I think I saw him ask Josh Boone if he needed a minute just to catch his breath. As you mentioned, Boone's been working hard both ends of the floor. So timeout is called here by Team Barstool to take a moment to get their breath here with 2:29 to go.
Yeah, just right there. I'm characteristic of Barrett, just careless with the ball in that situation. And That's a huge turnover and break for Notre Dame.
Championship game of the first annual The Basketball Tournament, TBT. We talked to people connected with the teams and with the tournament. They're hoping for a big crowd. I'm telling you right now, because we're on the roof, when they do that, when they jump like that, the whole floor shakes.
It is shaking.
You can feel it right now.
It is rocking. And I tell you what, 500 grand on the line.
Fighting alumni ball, and it's warm here in the building too. Again, very warm day outside in the low 80s. They nicknamed Case Jim the roof because we're on the top floor above Walter Proud Arena, so a little warm in this building right now. And in the fact they're playing for $500,000, and you get the idea. Battle on the inside, and Burrell's going to get called for the foul. Wow. He was fighting with Ty Nash, and Burrell gets whistled.
Barstool was looking for a three-second call, and Notre Dame was working the ball around, trying to isolate Ty Nash in the post. And let's see here. So they're battling inside right here. They've been physical all in the second half, and then that one right there might have been a little tough, but
it's the fifth personal foul for Burrell, who will stay on the court right now. Walsh is on the bench. 1-1. Front end is missed. Burrell with another rebound. Been really good on the glass. Barstool needs him to help Boone on the inside. Barrett. Guarded by Thomas. Returns it. Boone to the basket. And he'll go to the free throw line with a chance to tie the game with 1:56 to go.
I really like how Josh Boone has played. 14 Barstool. Again, nice setup. Barrett has been doing this all game. Nice little drop off, and that's one though that Boone knows he needs to finish in that situation for an and one.
Two free throws here for Boone. We mentioned before, struggle at the free throw line. Not on the first one.
Well, they can feel and sense the importance of these free throws.
Short, one a game. Less than 2 minutes to play. Thomas has been quiet, held in check. Kerr's wide open, look for three. No, Burrell controls another rebound for Team Barstool.
Well, you can't ask for a better look if your team Notre Dame. Wide open three.
Oh, look at Thomas getting after it. The steal to Carter, looking for the finish. Was looking for the big time finish but didn't get it, but he'll go to the free throw line to shoot two.
Well, Barrett seems like he was hurt on that play. There was a loose ball situation center court. I think he might have collided with somebody, and heads up play. Chris Thomas picked his pocket. Oh, that's a hard fall, and then Notre Dame's off to the races. Beautiful fast break. And
Jones whistled for the personal foul. A couple of free throws coming up for errors, and he makes the first.
We talked about pressure at the end of the game, how it impacts certain players, and free throws. One of the areas, end of the game, it's tired, you're tired, and you got a chance now if your errors to put your team up by three. Ice knocked him down. That's a big possession, two free throws for Notre Dame.
13 points now for Ryan Ayers. 3-point game. McGrath, excellent 3-point shooter. They don't need it right now. And now Burns is going to call a timeout.
And I like that timeout by Burns. Too much standing around that time on that possession by Barstool. They've got to get into their office. There's still plenty of time. Minute 14. You don't want one guy standing at the top dribbling the ball around. Get a couple swings, and I think you got to go back to Dante Jones.
Thank you. working with his team, keeping one eye here on Andre Barrett. As Malcolm mentioned, took a hard fall. He's still grabbing at his hip here a little bit. But he's going to stay in the game. When there's half a million on the line, you don't ask to come out of the game.
Ice and Advil the next morning, but 500 grand on the line. There's no way Andre Barrett is coming out of this game.
So Barrett will trigger the inbound here. Walsh is on the floor as Burrell goes to the bench. Let's see if they work it for McGrath or Jones. If they try to work a three, they look for the two. Boone bobbled it. Jones open three. Too strong. Rebound. Fighting alumni. Fighting for it and pulling it down is Nash. But then turned over. Walsh gets it back. Less than a minute to play with a half a million on the line. Walsh trying a three. Too strong. Thrown out of bounds by Thomas. It'll be Barstool basketball.
Well, that's two opportunities squandered by Team Notre Dame. First, just careless turnover, and then they don't come up with the defensive rebound and give Team Barstool another opportunity to tie this game up.
Walsh wanted the ball dried up. It's so much sweat here in this game right now. They're going to mop up the floor, and they just towel off the basketball. Shot clock reset, 43 seconds on the game clock. Three-point lead for the Fighting Alumni. McGrath made so many big threes in his time at Providence College. Will he take one here? Can he make one here? Too strong. Barrett kept it alive, and Jones is called for the foul. Foul on Dante Jones. We'll send Ryan Ayers to the free throw line.
Well, McGrath had a pretty good look. I still say Dante Jones should be touching the ball, but that's a pretty good look if you're Team Barstool. And you can see both teams want this, getting after it on the rebound.
Huge spot here for Ryan Ayers. Most recently played pro ball in Finland. Class of 09 at Notre Dame. Two possession game now with 29.4 to go.
Ayers has been huge in the second half for the Fighting Alumni.
15 points, 13 coming in the second half. 5-point lead for the Fighting Alumni. Here's Jones, lost the handle, but to Boone. Notre Dame really turning up the defense now as the clock winds down. Under 20 seconds to play. McGrath can't get free. Barrett will take it for two. The floater is no good. The follow put up by Boone. They say it was on the way up. Jones follows for three. No good. Down to 8 seconds, 7 seconds, 6 seconds, and a foul is called with 6.1 to go.
Game can sense victory and the opportunity to go home with a big check.
Russell Carter at the free throw line trying to add to a 5-point lead.
Big free throws. I think this one right here could seal the game.
1-2 for Carter. 5 seconds, 4 seconds. Dante Jones will take it coast to coast. Throws it down, but the half a million in the bank for the Fighting Alumni. They win the first annual basketball tournament. 72-68 is the final.
Well, from the start of the game, Eric, putting on an offensive clinic, loose balls, and I think the big factor was that they had 8 guys, they were able to get some rest, and they were the fresher team towards the end of this game.
And on the court with them is their longtime coach. Mike Bray gets out to celebrate with the Fighting Alumni as his former players all come over to meet him. He was in the middle of the confetti. He was one of the first guys on the court with Kieran Piller, former walk-on at Notre Dame, who coached this team. He's like, it's your time. But as Mike Bray told us during the first half, this Fighting Alumni team is going to make a donation to Coaches Versus Cancer. And they have the $500,000, Malcolm.
Oh, a Happy Gilmore moment. Somebody's walking out of here with a nice check.
Well, we've got Ty Nash on the headsets with us right now. Ty, you hear us all right?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Congratulations. What's it feel like to have a $500,000 in the bank for this team?
I've never seen that number, a big number like that on the check, and I don't even know, man. This is crazy, man. This is amazing.
You played great, Ty.
Yeah,
I mean,
man,
you can just tell you guys all fed off one another. What was the number one key for you guys to win this $500,000?
It was defense. We knew we had to play defense. We started a little sluggish in the first half, gave up a lot of 3-point shots. But we cut it down. In the second half, we grinded. We defended, we made some tough shots. We pulled it out, man. Play defense. Defense wins championships, and you see it right here.
Well, Ty, it seems like you guys got a great community in Notre Dame, but I want to ask you, did you guys discuss at all with Russell Carter what he is going to get Joe Brockington for his wedding? Because, he was supposed to be the best man in the wedding. I see you guys are still, but yeah. Have you guys discussed, because you can't get him something small. He was supposed to be the best man in the wedding. Have you guys discussed what you're going to get him and his soon-to-be wife?
You know what? No, we have no idea, but I know it's going to be something big.
Anything they want, right?
Anything he wants, man.
Ty, they got to get you a big check right now. Thanks for your time.
All right, thanks. Have a good night.
Time to present that $500,000 to the Notre Dame Fighting Alumni and the guy who pulled this tournament together with a great crew, John Mueger, ready to take things over at center court here at the TBT.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the basketball tournament's John Mueger for the presentation of the awards to the Notre Dame Fighting Alumni.
On behalf of the basketball tournament, we wanted to, first of all, thank the 32 teams that played and over 150 teams that participated online by applying. We especially wanted to thank Team Barstool. It was an extremely competitive tournament, and to win 4 straight games to be here tonight is quite an accomplishment. And of course, we want to thank the Notre Dame Fighting Alumni. It's a team that really epitomizes what this tournament's all about, a group of guys that went to school together and reunited for the past 2 months on this journey. And before we present you with your prize, I wanted to introduce our 2014 fan leader, Lindsay Mitchell, who is holding the check. Lindsay is a guest of ours all the way from Chicago, because she led all other fans on thetournament.com in points this year. And she did it by recruiting 370 of her friends and family into thetournament.com single-handedly. So Lindsay will present the check, and official congratulations to the 2014 TBT champions, Notre Dame Fighting Alumni.
Well, the first year, a memorable event here at Case Gym as the Fighting Alumni all together getting their check for $500,000. They took the big giant check away from you, Malcolm. I'm sorry.
Well, what an event this was, though.
It was great.
The atmosphere in this gym, the level of play here, we talked about it. There were some really good players starting off in the early rounds, and then in this championship game, they did not disappoint. Impressive on both ends, but there was only one that can go home with that big check. And this year, for the first one, the Fighting alumni of Notre Dame are going home with a lot of extra pocket change.
They've got it all figured out amongst the players. You get played upwards of 50 grand is the cap for an individual player. And as we mentioned before, they're going to give a chunk, a good chunk, a sizable chunk to charity. So the first TBT is in the books, a successful event. I think it's only going to get bigger as the years go along. We enjoy bringing it to you tonight here from Boston. Once again, the final score, the Notre Dame Fighting Alumni 72, Team Barstool 68. They win the $500,000 prize. For Malcolm Huckabee and our crew, I'm Eric Fried saying so long for Boston. Thanks for joining us.